Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll be covering how to import web page data into Google Sheets using ImportHTML function. This function will allow us to grab tables or lists from a web page and import them right into Google Sheets. Remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and let's get right into using the ImportHTML function. We can get started by typing equal ImportHTML. Another way that we could use this is ImportXML function. That's using XPaths. It's a little more complicated, and leave a comment below if you'd like to see that function as well. So there's a few things we'll need. We can click this dropdown to kind of guide us. So there'll be a URL. So let's say, for example, we have this table that is on this web page by Worldometer, and we want to import this country data into Google Sheets. What we're going to want to do is copy this URL here. We'll go back to our spreadsheet, and then we'll need this to be double quotations, the URL. So we can follow along. Next will be query, so we will need a table or a list. And it is included down here, so either table or list will also be in double quotes, depending on what type of structure contains the desired data. So import HTML is saying import, and then the coding language HTML, or hypertext markup language, which is used to structure a web page. So how we'll know if we want to import a table or a list will depend on the web page. For this example, this looks like a table, kind of like a classic matrix of data. So you can think of it as in Google Sheets table, where it has rows and columns. And most of the time, whenever you see this in a web page, it will be a table. But how you could check if you try importing it and it doesn't work will be by right-clicking, inspect the web page. And so there'll be a lot of different structures here included on the web page. But if you press Control F, you can find here. And if you do a opening bracket and look up table, it'll be included in this body. So hovering over it will show us that this is the table. So this is indeed a table. We can go back. And now we can put a comma and in double quotes type table. And so now the last one that we will need is index, as locale will be a language or region locale used when parsing the data. So the, in this example, won't be needed. And in most scenarios, you can leave that blank as it is optional. So the index starting at 1 identifies which table or list as defined by the HTML source, or saying through that structure which one will come first as they're indexed. So we can type 1 with this being the first table. Warning, some features or some formulas are trying to send and receive data from external parties. We can allow. And this imports the table. So this will be a really quick way to get tables, especially if there's a web page with multiple tables. You'll be able to change this index from 1 to however many are included on the web page. And so for the next example, we'll be using ImportHTML for a list. And so URL will be different this time. We'll be in Wikipedia. And so the last one looked like a table or a matrix. This one will just look like a list. So it'll have bullets of items listed. So we'll be able to tell that this is a list. We could also go to inspect. And then in the body, there will be a list, which will be in brackets UL for unordered list, and then list items. So LI will be the list items, and we scroll through, we can see that these are the elements within the web page. So we can copy this URL and then paste this in between double quotations. And then this time it will be a list. And then it looked like there were multiple lists within that web page. So we can start by putting 1. And we can actually try 0 here, with 0 being the first index. And it does look like 0 is the correct one. And this lists all the items in one cell with the base of the list and then also what is listed underneath. And there'll be a way to separate this list. So this will just be working with other Google Sheets functions. We could type equals split And then in this case, the delimiter will be a hyphen. And then if you wanted this all in one column, we could just type equals to call. So once you get it into Google Sheets, there are a bunch of different formulas that you can get to format correctly, or if you just want the sheet in here to look at and list items, it'll be perfect as is. And so this will be a quick way to get these web page elements into Google Sheets with a easy to use formula. But that's all I have for you in this video. If you enjoyed the video, remember to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.